to SFTtv, your source for news, analysis, and updates. This is TenDolkar, SFT USA Grassroots Director, and your host for this evening. And we're reporting from SFT India in Dharamsala. Last Thursday and Friday, Shogdung and Kelsang Tsultrim were released on bail, respectively, by the Chinese government. There were no statements of reason as to why they were released, since they were arrested on alleged crime of inciting to split the nation, the highest offense against the Chinese Communist Party. It can only be fairly assumed that the Chinese government has done so, taken this action because of what has happened in the case of Liu Xiaobo, one of the most prominent Chinese dissident and democracy activist who was locked up for his views and opinions and then later recognized by the Chinese, by the international community and awarded the Nobel Peace Prize. Now the Chinese government thinking that by releasing Shogdung and Kelsang Tsultrim that the Tibetan people and the international community would forget them and their work is wrong because they continue to arrest Tibetan writers and intellectuals. A prominent Tibetan writer and activist in her own rights living in Beijing wrote a post about these three particular Tibetan writers who were arrested within months of each other after publishing essays and articles in this very popular student journal called Shogdung. And these very young Tibetan writers named Dhonko, Buddha, and Kelsang Jinpa wrote about the human rights situation in Tibet following the 2008 uprising. And for that, they were arrested. Their current whereabouts are unknown. Their family members have not seen them since June and July. And the Chinese government, and the Chinese government thinks that, by just releasing these two, Shogdung and Kelsang Tsultrim, that the rest could be forgotten. As Tibetans inside Tibet continue to show courage and bravery in light in the face of Chinese brutality, we are here with SFT India, who's organizing the 12th Free Tibet Action Camp, training the next generation of Tibetan student activists and Indian student activists for the Free Tibet movement. So let's just go upstairs and take a look at the office. Everyone, having concluded SFT India's Free Tibet Action Camp 12, we'll be posting up photos on our website, on our blog, and on our Flickr account, so please be sure to check them out. Concurrently, as we were hosting our leadership conference for our next generation of student activists and leaders, there were student protests in Tibet, in the northeastern province of Amdo, in Rabkong, and in Chabcha, starting from October 19th. An estimated 6,000 students, mostly Tibetan middle school students, took to the streets demanding for freedom of language. And this protest was sparked by this new language policy in which the Tibetan language was to be replaced by Chinese language as the medium for instruction in Tibetan schools. And these Tibetan students' demands were simple. They were asking for equality of races and freedom of language. And these protests sparked solidarity protests by Tibetan students in the neighboring province of Camp, as well as in a university in Beijing. SFT members worldwide, students and supporters likewise, also organized rallies and protests in support of these Tibetan students' protests inside Tibet. Students and teachers in East Turkestan have also shown strong support of these language rights protests inside Tibet. In retaliation, the Chinese government detained 20 students in Chabcha Amdo on October 22nd, and as of right now, there are no updates as to their whereabouts. And the Tibetan language being the foundation of the Tibetan culture and the collective identity of the Tibetan people, the Chinese government's calculated measure to implement this new language policy reveals their intention to assimilate Tibetans into Chinese society, and also to destroy a language that unifies Tibetans inside Tibet and in exile. And the unification of the Tibetan people is obviously the ultimate threat to the Chinese government, to their stability, and to their illegal occupation of Tibet. And these language protests extends beyond this new language policy in schools, beyond the Tibetan middle school student protests, beyond the classrooms. Point in case, there was a protest led by over 700 Tibetan monks and nuns in Zakchuka, asserting their right to freedom of language, to their freedom to speak, to learn, to write in Tibetan. And this protest was sparked by an incident on October 26th in which Chinese officials from the county and official from the United Work Front Department went into Sershul Monastery and confiscated a box containing money. And this box collected fine for speaking drake. Drake is a reference used to describe spoken a mixture of spoken Tibetan and Chinese. So what was happening was Tibetan people who caught themselves speaking a mixture of Tibetan and Chinese would voluntarily pay a fine into this box. And what the Chinese officials did was they came in, confiscated the box, and demanded that they stop the system, in which they had no right whatsoever to say so or demand so. So what we will do is we'll continue to cover the story as it develops. So please continue to check back on our website, on our blog, and on SFTtv. Until the next time, please do your part for Tibet.